Hello, happy Tuesday. I've got some friends here with me today.
Hello.
Hi.
And we are ready for total body strength. And today's class will be different from other total body strengths we've done because it's just a little bit longer. It is 45 minutes. We usually do half an hour, so we're going to do a little more of an extensive warm-up today to really get our bodies ready, and we'll have an extra circuit in mind. And we will also have a lot of options for different modifications and options along the way. As I usually do, we'll do things for time. That way we can all take it at our own pace. And since I'm going to have Justin practicing with me today, that's going to help out because if we do a modification, there'll be times where he might be able to show a different variation. That was your dad that just did all those hearts.
Okay. Yeah, I know from experience.
Okay, we've got some people hopping on. We'll just allow for about another minute to see if anybody else joins us today. It's not the sunniest day outside, but it feels amazing. It's a great day to work out. I think there's supposed to be some rain ahead for tomorrow, which is kind of a bummer, so we might have to do class inside tomorrow.
Hey, at least you guys get to see the cats again.
Yeah, that's the advantage, right? The silver lining is to see the kitty cats when we're indoors. Okay, so just to make sure that we get started on time, especially for those that might be like on a lunch break or something, we'll go ahead and kind of pop up and begin our warm up again. This is going to be a 45 minute class, so if you can't stick with us through the whole thing, do make sure that you do a cool down, even if that is on your own time, even if it's just some simple walking, stretching, making sure that we stay hydrated. A friendly reminder to always have permission from your doctor before actively participating. Of course, you're always welcome to follow along and watch in the meantime. So I'm gonna go ahead and get set up here. Oop, how do we? There we go. Okay, Mr. Cameraman.
All right, Justin, let's do this. We are gonna get started with our warm up here. So if you go ahead and come to standing, first part of our warm-up, we will be standing. So start with your feet together. For 30 seconds, we are just going to do some half jacks. It's a jumping jack modification. Okay, so starting with the right arm, we're just gonna go tap, tap, just every other side. Yep. You can have a little slight bend in your knees here as we go side to side. Make sure you're breathing in and out. It really helps to set a really good foundation with your breath to help us keep nice and strong and have good stamina all the way through. Just think of this first part as getting things moving. Do one more on each side, and we're gonna go full on jumping jacks. Breathing in and out. Nice light bounce. If you're needing something more low impact, you can keep with your taps that we just did. So jumping jack, everything out here. Less than 5 seconds. We're going 3, 2, 1. All right, moving on to some arm circles here. Go ahead and bring those arms out to a T position. And we're just gonna create little circles in one direction. So just getting some more blood flow going here. Breathing in and out. Go ahead and circle the opposite way. Getting some nice resistance going. Let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job. Drop them down. Just give them a brief little rest here. And we're going to create a wider stance with our legs. We're going to take our arms back out to T, and we're just going to do some opposite toe touches. So you'll reach to either toe. And it's okay if you don't tap. We're just preparing our bodies and making sure that we're getting the legs a little bit more woken up. We're crossing that middle line of the body. You can take it at your own pace. You can go nice and super slow, or maybe quick. Let's go for about 15 more seconds on these. Nice. We'll do one more tap to each toe. Okay, go ahead and just bring yourself back up to standing. And we're gonna come around to the floor. So you can always be on a mat or if you're indoors and have a soft surface, maybe you just go right on the floor. We're gonna do a 30-second plank hold. So pick any variation of plank. We're just simply using this to wake up the core, wake up the arms, and kind of activate everything in the body. So I'm just gonna do a regular high plank. Pick what works for you. So 3, 2, 1, we'll go ahead and go. So making sure that we don't neglect our breath here. You're breathing in and out. If you need to modify at any time, that's fine. We're halfway there. Chest, shoulders, arms strong. The core's engaged for 3, 2, 1. Drop on down. Nice job. Let's come around to our spines and we're going to do a 30-second glute bridge hold to really wake up those glutes and kind of waking up a little more through the back body. So roll on down, feet are flat to the mat, knees bent, we're hip width apart here, arms down by the sides, palms down, take a nice deep inhale, exhale, rise up, so lift your hips up to the sky, press down through your arms and palms. Imagine that you can hold and squeeze something between the inner thighs, that'll kind of wake them up and keep them engaged. Think of firing through your glutes and pressing through your heels. More than halfway there. We're breathing in and out. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it down nice and easy. Okay, let me grab my cheat sheet here. We're gonna get started on our first circuit. So keeping down on the ground, we're gonna come around to table pose, or it's just all fours. And so for some of these movements, everything's gonna be done for a minute, but if we've got a movement that requires one side each, we'll split it into 30 seconds on the right and 30 seconds on the left, which is gonna be the case with this first one. So hands and knees here, you are gonna take the right leg behind you, so you can bring the toe tucked, the leg is long. We're simply gonna do a little leg lift and squeeze. Put it down, lift, and crunch. So just like that, let's go ahead and start. So we lift, crunch, long, down. Yep. So you'll find your own rhythm here. It might not exactly match mine. The idea is to get some glute and core work in here. So when our leg is long, we squeeze the glute, lower down, the core is engaged the whole time, and then we're really crunching when we bring this in. One more full round on this side. Crunch. And other side. So take left leg long, we're gonna lift it, lift, and crunch. So it's always okay to modify. If it's too much to think about, maybe you just do your lifts, maybe you just do your crunches here. So as long as we're keeping nice and safe, give yourself room to kind of make it your own, to make it work for you. As long as we've got proper form, that's what matters. One more full one. Okay, good job. So go ahead and drop it on down. We are going to shift to doing side plank. We're gonna do 30 seconds on each side. And so again, variation of your choice. You could do the forearm variation. You could always bring your knee down. You could do a high side plank. Or we could even modify and go here. Which one do you think you're going to do today?
It depends on if my legs get tired.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good response. He's going to listen to his body. So let's go ahead and pick either side. Begin. So we might show just a mix of each one here. I think that I'm going to go half high, half modified. So we're halfway through. I'm going to go ahead and drop down and modify. Less than 10 seconds on this side. We're going 3, 2, 1, rest. So switch it out. So I'm simply just going to face the other way. Start to set yourself up here for 3, 2, 1, go. So if we are in the high plank version like mine, just make sure that you're lifting up and out of that shoulder. It's okay if you face that way, Justin. The arm is engaged, the core is engaged. We're really squeezing through those obliques. We're more than halfway there. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rest. Okay, good job. We are now going, shifting back to some glute work and moving into some clamshells. So again, these are singles. We've got a right side and a left side, so just start on either side. You're gonna lay down. You're gonna bend your legs and stack everything. So we've got stacked hips, knees, and ankles together. And so take an inhale. As we exhale, we're gonna open that top thigh and feel a little squeeze in that top glute. Lower down. We're helping to use our inner thigh to control on the way down too. And these are kind of funny because normally you think things are harder when you go fast, but I almost think the slower you go on these, the more you feel it. It doesn't hurt to be nice and controlled. Make sure you've got a nice supportive base arm too. Let's go for two more. All right, and switch. You can just flip over or flip around. Either one's fine. So remembering, bend through your knees, everything stacked. Take an inhale. Exhale, open up and squeeze. So think glutes and inner thighs, making that mind-muscle connection. We're still breathing in and out. 10 more seconds to go. Woo. We're going for two more reps. And rest. Good job. So in this circuit, we have one more movement to go. So we're going to come around kind of like a modified, I call this reverse cable. So you'll be on your seat. Your fingertips are going to face towards you. Yep. So different options here. Before we start our time, I'll kind of go over this one because this one's new to us. And okay, so hands are here. Ideally, our seat is a little bit lifted off the ground. So the nice happy medium is that we're just going to kick each alternate leg. So engage your core. So if we're doing the harder one, you're going to actually make it adjust. So just be careful you don't take it. So that's going to be the harder version. A nice modification is to have your seat on the ground and to just kick from here. So find what works for you. Maybe you do a mix of all of it. So we're going to try to go for a full minute. You can always mix it up if you need to drop down your energy level along the way. So 3, 2, 1, let's go. I'm going to do my happy medium for a lot of it here. Always do a little spurt of those pops along the way. Since we're on the deck, I know it's going to be kind of loud if we do jump, but hey, that's okay. As long as you don't break it, right?
Yeah.
I know, it takes a little bit of coordination, and make sure you've got a soft bend in your elbows. Because it's a lot of tricep work, too. More than halfway there, guys. So we're working the full body here. If your arms become fatigued, you'll just come onto your seat and continue to kick. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Way to finish strong. So we're taking a rest. After we rested out here for about the next 50 seconds, we are going to come into that circuit one more time. So we've got 3 circuits all together today. So just kind of taking some time to breathe, to catch your breath. Heart rate is still going. Remembering that that first movement in our circuit is the table pose. We're doing a mix between those leg lifts and abdominal crunches. So let's just start to get back in place. We're coming around to hands and knees. Got fingertips spread nice and wide. We're nice and stacked. It's like a table we'd want to build. We're going to start with the right leg first. Let's go ahead and begin. So bring it long. Leg lift. Squeeze through the glutes. Lift it back up and crunch. Lift, lift, and crunch. Again, don't stress too much about making it perfectly match my rhythm. As long as you're using proper form, do what feels natural. One more full one. Okay, bring it back down table, switch out. And left leg. Core is engaged. Anytime you're shooting that left leg long, make sure you're squeezing through the back body and your glute. Good job, Justin. 15 seconds to go. You've got this. We're almost there for 5 more seconds. One more full breath. And done with those for the day. Moving back onto side plank. So pick either side. Your variation here, I think I'm going to change it up on this one and do forearm plank. So do whatever feels right to you. Maybe you take the modification this round, listening to your body. Let's begin in 3, 2, 1, plank. So remember, it's just 30 seconds since we're doing one side each. Arms and shoulders plugged in, the core is strong, the breath is moving. Modify along the way if you need to, that's totally fine. And we're 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it down safely. Okay, switching out. In 3, 2, 1, other side. Nice job. Think of really engaging through those side abdominals, especially the side that's near the floor. Halfway there. Breathing it out for strength. And we're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it down. Good. We are going back to our clamshells here. So I'm gonna go back to my right side. You can start on either side. We're gonna hit both. So we lay on the side, have your arm here for support. Remember to stack the joints together, knees are bent. And let's begin. Open up, squeeze. Lower with control, yep. Breathe in, out. Always, just for future reference, if it's a lot on the hip, you can always place like a towel or a cushion underneath for support on this one too. Almost there. 2 more breaths. And finishing out, we're going to switch out sides. Even out our glutes. So stacking, getting things in place, and let's start. Squeeze. your breath. Making that mind-muscle connection. So for me, I've got my right leg on top here, so does Justin. So as you open, kind of thinking of squeezing through that right glute and inner thigh to get the most out of each rep. We've got two more to go. Good job. We are done with our clamshells. And going back to that really new fun one, the reverse table. So just keep in mind that the arms are engaged here. Even though it's like we're kind of thinking about our lower body, those arms are going to be what supports you. And that little bend in the elbows will help keep things nice and safe. Fingertips pointed towards you. Go ahead and take your variation. I'm going to show a mix of several. So this is our nice, easy, safe one. If we stay on our seat, just kick, just feel those squeeze in the legs, engage the core. Happy medium is our seat's a little lifted. We're just going to engage our arms a little bit more. Yep. If you're working out with a friend, just don't kick your neighbor in the head. So I'll do a little spurt of my jumping one here. Helps to engage the core with this one. It looks kind of silly, but man, whoo, it's a workout. Okay, that's enough. We're down to the 10-second mark. We're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest it out. You earned it. That completes the second round of our first circuit. So we are done with those movements. And as you rest, we are going to safely transition to coming up to standing. So we've been on our seats for a while. So just be sure that you come up nice and easy. Take your time. If you start to feel lightheaded, go ahead and just come back down to a seat. So this round is going to involve some optional weights. Justin's going to use a basketball. If you've got dumbbells handy or something to hold on to, if not, just use imaginary weights. You could do canned goods. The first one that we're going to do is going to be a wood chop variation with a squat. I'm just going to hold one 8-pound dumbbell for mine. He's going to use the basketball. So let's go ahead and move and start together. We're going to alternate the direction of our wood chops and have a squat in between. So start with the wood chop down to the left, little bend, bring it through the middle, opposite right corner, to the heart, and squat. Now we're going to go to the other side. So to the right, through the middle, opposite corner, middle, squat, back to the beginning. Squat. So we're using the whole body, right, squat, other side. We're halfway through. Let your movement come from the core. Breathe. To the right. And left. This is going to be our last one. Okay, great job. Nice. So these are fun. Single leg deadlifts. I'm not going to use a weight. If you have any issues with balance or these are new to you, please hold on to the wall, rail, chair, something beside you. So turning to the side, we're going to have our left leg be the strong standing leg. I'm going to kind of bring my right leg behind me a little bit. I'm going to try to reach towards the ground with my right fingertips. It's okay if you don't go all the way down, okay? If you wobble, if you fall, that's okay. Just stand on back up and rejoin us. No big deal. Know that you can always hold on to something for safety. So you're going to lift that back leg up. Use the standing leg to draw yourself up. So just like that, back and forth, you can go as slow as you need to. So it's more about stability here. We're halfway through on this side. Don't worry about getting in a bunch of reps. This is where I'd be holding on to something for 6 seconds. So I'm gonna go for one more and then we'll switch sides. Good, it's not easy, is it? Okay, so shifting, right leg is now our balanced leg. I'm using something for balance, I'm holding on with my right arm. And here we go, it's okay to have a slight bend in your knee. It's okay if they're not pretty. Engage your core for health. So stability exercises are so important. They help to prevent injury. They help to have a more well-rounded core. They help to promote strength in those larger muscle areas. And done. So trying to see if we make sure to weave some of those in. So go ahead and grab that basketball. So grab some dumbbells. I'm gonna use two. You could also just use one object like he's gonna do with the basketball. We're just gonna do some curl to presses. So go ahead, engage your core, get your weight or imaginary weight ready, and we'll begin. So little bicep curl, bring it in. We're pressing up, lower down with control, extend, curl, press. Good. So nice and easy, making sure that you are using a weight that you can execute proper form with. If you can't control the weight, then it's too heavy. We're more than halfway through. Use your core for help. Make sure that it's engaged, that it's not being lazy. We're down to 10 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we'll set these aside for now. Whew. As we move on to, okay, we're gonna combine a squat jump with a standing cross crunch. So if a squat jump is too much impact for you, you can skip the jump and just do a squat. We're gonna do our hands behind our head no matter what variation. So we'll begin, so I'm gonna squat, jump, land, and then I'll come up, crunch left, crunch right. So just like that. Got it, yep. Nice easy landing. So remember, skip the jump if it's too much. So really squeezing that alternate side abdominal here as we do our cross crunches. More than halfway through. Make sure you breathe with every breath. Down to the 10 second mark. Woo. One more full one. Okay, nice job. Woo, we get to rest for a little bit. So, we're gonna come into that one more time. Catch your breath a little bit here. You remember, we're going back to the wood chops with a squat in between. So lots of squatting on this round of our circuit. We've still got a little more time for our rest. So 45 minutes is a longer workout to do something a little more intense like this. So just hang with me as long as you can. Don't feel any shame if you need to rest and rejoin us or if you need to simply watch. For part of it, that's okay. We're still learning. We're still engaging here together. So start to get yourself in place. Set yourself up for those wood chops. So you've got your weight or your prop or just imaginary holding something right here at the chest. Legs are a little bit wide. Let's begin. We're going to dip down to the left, little bend. through the middle, other corner, middle, squat. To the right. Squat. Yep. Nice and controlled. Other side. Remembering that attitude of quality over quantity. Make every part of the rep count. Don't worry about speed. Find your rhythm. Good job, Justin. Getting closer. Sorry, I don't think you're right. This next one will be our last one. Okay, done with those for the day. Back to your favorite single leg deadlifts. Gotta get that stability in. So right leg is gonna be the strong standing leg. Engage it, little bend in the knee. Core is engaged, try to keep the back flat, even if it means you don't go down as far. Ready? Look like a teeter-totter, yep. Up nice and slow, fire through that back leg. Remember, they don't have to be pretty. This is just part of improving your balance, your proprioception here. Last one on this side. And switching out. Stabilize your right leg as the standing leg and go. Using glute and hamstring, draw your body back up. Really rely on the core on the way down. Remember, it's okay to hold on to something, especially for safety. Ten seconds. Good. Whew. Okay, we're done. Not easy. So go ahead and find your weights for curl to overhead press. So either using one object here like the basketball, or maybe you've got a weight in both hands, or maybe you just hold one weight like I did with wood chop. Engage your core and let's go. So finding your curl to press. Bring it down with control. You're either breathing in or out on each part of the rep. Nice and easy. Core is engaged. If the weight becomes too heavy throughout the time interval, you can always just go ahead and set it down. If you've got other weights handy, you can drop your weight. Closer. And we're going for 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Okay, last movement in this circuit, and then we'll be done with this one, is our squat jump to standing cross crunch. So get yourself set up on the bottom half here, shoulder width apart, hands behind the head. We'll go ahead and start. So squat, either jump or just stand back up, and cross crunch it out to each side. If you are jumping, just make sure you come down toe ball heel, nice soft landing, control it. Using those alternate abs. And crunch. Whew. Crunch it out. More than halfway. Good job. Squeeze. Almost there. One more full one and then we're done. Crunch, crunch. Good. We get to rest. All right. We have one more circuit to go. Remember, we do have to do it 2 times, so we're more than halfway. We're 2/3 of the way through our workout. Okay, so give yourself a rest. This final circuit is gonna rely more on floor work here. So we're gonna go ahead and get prepared on our mats. We're gonna start by standing at the back of our mat. So this first movement is going to be an inchworm to 2 slow mountain climbers. You walk yourself back in and stand back up. If that isn't doable to keep walking back in and out with your inchworming, you can just stay in your plank and do your slow mountain climbers or work on holding plank too. So getting our time clock ready, and let's go ahead and start. So bending down, we're gonna walk it forward. So right knee, or either one, just both in and you'll walk yourself back in. So Justin's gonna work on his climbers, good. Listening to your body, you're going to do what works for you. So a lot going on here, a lot of core strength, a lot of upper body strength. We're halfway there. So know that you can rest when you need to. You can even finish out and like hold a modified plank. Nice. Less than 15 seconds to work. Getting closer. I've got time for like one more full one here, and then we'll finish there. Okay, dropping down. We are going to come into our bird dog. We're gonna hold each side for 30 seconds. So the prep for that is table pose. We come onto hands and knees. So it's opposite arm and leg. You can start with either one. Let's go ahead and start. So think stability again here. So if you're feeling a lot of shaking and wobbling, that's why. It's a lot of stabilizer muscles having to kick in. The more we practice these over time, the more those little muscles learn how to work hard and really hug in towards the bones. For 3, 2, 1, bring it down. Other side. And for a good modification, you can always, yep, drop down an arm, or you could drop down a leg, or you could just hold table and think of just working your core. Russian twist. If you can't twist it out for the full minute, you can always just hold a modified boat pose here or here. So let's go ahead, get ready, and begin. So just right to left. If you want to make it more challenging and you have your weights handy, you can always hold a weight here. So twisting, seeing if we can keep our back flat. Really squeezing those side abs as we shift from right to left. Right. Oh, I hear you, man. I think Justin said he's ready for a protein shake after this. What about you, Lucas? Is your arm getting a good workout? Less than 10 seconds. And we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job.
Okay, this is gonna be a strong finish. We're gonna see if we can go for push-ups. For a whole minute. You can do any variation that you like. You can even just do a plank variation. Rest along the way as you need to. I'm gonna do just a mix of full and modified push-ups today. So just know that you can always modify. I definitely will be at some point. Okay, so pace yourself because we're going for a minute. Let's go ahead and start. So nice and strong. Breathing in and out. Child's pose if you want to take a little rest. It's a challenge, especially towards the end of a workout. Think of working the arms, working the core and the chest. Less than 10. We're going to go for one more. Press back, little child's pose, breathe. Rest it out. Guys, we are almost through this workout. You're doing a great job. Stick with me, even if you're just watching, if you can. We're going for that circuit one more time, and then we're gonna cool down nice and easy. If you need to rest, just rest, okay? Here, sit and breathe. It is a longer workout than usual. Okay, so, yes. Listening to your body is what's important. If you're sticking with me, we're gonna go for one more round. So, remembering it's inchworms to your slow mountain climbers, or just mountain climbers or some type of plank. So let's go ahead and start. Walking out some prone. Slow climber, walk back in. So I'm taking a nice easy pace here to really focus on my form. Keeping the core strong, halfway there. Remembering you can mix up your variations throughout the time interval. I think I may have just felt a sprinkle.
It's starting to.
Is it? Okay. Let's see if we can get through it. This is the last one. All right, moving on to bird dog hold. Let's get right to it. Opposite arm and leg, go. See if we can go for that. Full 30 seconds. Think of toe and fingertips reaching long away from each other. Think of the core activated. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, other side. Body is plugged in. Halfway there. All right, we've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, finish. Shifting around, brush and twist. So find kind of that boat pose prep here. Lean back, back is flat, twisting. Right. halfway there. More seconds. Keeping the energy strong. Let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's see if we can finish out with those push-ups. Running around, knocking out this last one, and go. Really rely on your breath on these. I like to think of breathing in as I lower down, breathe out my strong, push back up. Staying connected, keeping with me for this last little leg. We're halfway through. Seconds. Down to 10. I'm gonna go for one more. All right, little press back. Okay, you guys did it. Let's just do a brief little cool down here. Since we're already down on the floor, we'll just come to a little seat to stretch those legs long. Reach down to the toes, just breathe. So take as much time as you need to just sit and breathe and stretch until you feel like your body is starting to return to that normal baseline. Grab a sip of water. Maybe a little butterfly pose. So I'll run through these fairly quickly and just know you can go back and hold them for longer along the way if you like. Stretch up and over. So doing a cool down is going to help with recovery. It's going to help prevent as much muscle soreness. It also keeps us safe so that we don't get too lightheaded after a workout. It helps our breathing and kind of blood flow kind of all return to normal. If you can, maybe even kind of taking a light walk, even if it's just around your house. So, great job, everybody. Way to finish strong. Tomorrow we'll have Relax and Restore Yoga, which will be a great recovery day if you participated in this today. So hopefully I'll see you then.